Hey guys, what's up? My name is Eric and I'm the Techie Agent, and today we're taking a look at the brand new Garmin VivoActive 3. So the VivoActive 3 is, of course, the third VivoActive watch from Garmin, and it's a completely new design.
Now, in this video, we will cover features, and I will show you real-world results that I experienced in the gym doing strength training and other gym-based exercise. And I'm also going to show you the results of my steady-state cardio exercise as well. But first, let's go ahead and take a look at some of the features of the VivoActive 3. So first, Garmin claims that the watch will get 7 days of battery life. But in my experience, it was actually closer to 4 days with moderate exercise and notifications enabled. This is about the same as the previous generation VivoActive, so nothing really to speak of here. Now, the touchscreen on this is very snappy. It's a significant improvement over the previous generation touchscreen responsiveness. Additionally, it's obviously now a circular design versus the previous rectangular and square designs. It's also brighter and clearer, and I've had no issues seeing the screen in both indoor and outdoor settings. The display is always on, and it is a color screen. Now, Garmin has several dozen, if not more, watch faces that you can select from, and they are continually being added to. So if customization or variety is your thing, this is a fantastic option. The watch looks nice, and even though it is mostly plastic, the watch has a metal edge or bevel around the face of the watch, and the metal backing on the back of the device also gives it a slightly more premium look. And although these are mostly cosmetic touches and not really design factors, I think it does do a good job making the watch have a versatile look for both formal and casual settings. The all-plastic design of the previous generation watches definitely needed some improvement, and I think Garmin did a good job updating the cosmetics on this new version of the watch. Now, the watch strap does not have Garmin's quick disconnect feature like some of their higher-end watches, but perhaps even better is that it uses standard watch straps with a quick disconnect pin design for easy swapping of the bands. So if you want to upgrade to leather bands or something else, the process is still very easy. Now, the watch has three different ways of interacting with the user interface. There is a designated button that is used as a home button when you're not in workout mode, and then that button can also be used to start, pause, and stop exercise when you are in a workout mode. You'll also get a touch screen, obviously, that allows you to swipe up or down, left and right, and it will also allow you to long press the screen for accessing settings and other menus. You'll also get an all-new touch sensor on the side of the watch that allows you to scroll through the menus on the watch without touching the screen. So I think they're providing that feature if you don't want to leave fingerprints on your screen. Now, the screen is Gorilla Glass 3, and if you get the black gunmetal version of the watch, you'll get an additional scratch-resistant coating, but that watch is also going to run you $329 versus the $299. Now, that coating does fade over time, so my recommendation here is to just go with whatever watch you like the look of best, as the Gorilla Glass 3 on all of these watches is going to hold up very well against scratches and minor impacts. Now, the previous generation VivoActive had a plastic screen, and it was definitely prone to scratching, so it's nice to see that they've upgraded to a quality glass screen. It's also worth noting that this screen is the exact same size screen that is used on the Garmin Fenix 5X. Now, that's Garmin's top tier GPS watch, and it's the exact same size and everything, the only difference being that the Fenix 5X uses sapphire glass instead of the Gorilla Glass 3, but in terms of everyday use, you're not really going to see any difference there. The watch is water resistant up to 50 meters, and the watch does include designated sports profiles for all kinds of exercise, including cycling, running, strength training, cardio, hiking, skiing, swimming, golf, even yoga, and many, many more. Now, you are also given the option of creating your own customized workout profiles. Additionally, all of the data screens for each workout profile are completely customizable, so you can arrange the data and the metrics that it's showing you while you work out to be wherever you want it to be and arrange it however you like it. The VivoActive 3 has a heart rate sensor on the back of the device, and it measures both active and resting heart rate data. Now, I'll have more on the accuracy of that sensor in a moment, but I wanted to highlight that this watch does feature Garmin's proprietary version of heart rate variability. So the watch will take automatic periodic readings to measure your heart rate variability and let you know how your exercise or lack of exercise is affecting your body and stress levels. Now, getting a high stress score just basically means you need to get better sleep or rest, or that you've been exercising a little bit too much. And a low stress score means that you're potentially able to push yourself a little harder in terms of exercise and fitness. The watch will also give you your VO2 max estimate, which is a very important metric for those of you competing in cardio sports. Now, in regards to tracking sensors, Garmin did not leave anything out. This has GPS with GLONASS. It does have a barometric altimeter for recording altitude information. It has a built-in compass for heading information, and it even has a built-in thermometer for capturing ambient temperatures. It connects to both Bluetooth and ANT Plus accessories. That includes heart rate sensors, foot pods, cadence sensors, and much more. Now, in terms of all-day tracking, of course, you'll get your stress score, but you'll also get your all-day steps, distance, calories, heart rate information, sleep, what Garmin calls your fitness age, and of course, there's lots of other metrics that it collects and will give you. You'll also get a move bar with reminders to move if you've been inactive for too long, although this is a feature that can be disabled if you find it annoying. For exercise, you can set up the watch to alert you if you fall out of a certain heart rate zone, and this can be helpful for those of you wanting to train in a very specific heart rate zone. This also features rep counting and automatic exercise recognition for gym-based exercise, and I found this to be one of the most surprisingly accurate parts of this watch, and more on that in a moment. One of the newest features debuting on the VivoActive 3 are mobile payments. So you can enter in credit card information on the app, and it takes that credit card information and puts it on the watch, which then you can use for mobile payments at retailers that accept NFC mobile payments. And that's going to be nearly every large-scale retailer at this point. You'll also get the ability to adjust your screen brightness. Obviously, the brighter the screen, the more this will impact your battery life. And then you also have the option of being able to geotag a specific location if you'd like to be able to navigate or locate that location later on. So let's go ahead and talk about the accuracy and real-world experience that I had with the Garmin VivoActive 3. Now, I liked the old VivoActive HR. It was my daily wearable for quite a while, but this watch takes fitness and exercise tracking to the next level. For gym-based exercise, this thing absolutely blew me away. The heart rate sensor did okay, although we still haven't got past the place where optical heart rate sensors do as well as chest straps or other external sensors, but I would say that this heart rate sensor is up there in terms of being, you know, one of the better ones on the market for accuracy for exercise. And I would still recommend, though, using an external chest strap or armband to track heart rate data for gym-based exercise. What made this watch so surprising to me for gym-based exercise was the automatic rep counting and exercise detection. It was able to detect my reps with amazing accuracy, and the time between the sets was also recorded. And in some cases, in many cases, I correctly identified my exercise. Now, after each set, you can easily edit the reps if the watch maybe missed a rep or added a rep. And you can also input the weight that you used on that set. And you can also review and edit this information in the app after you're done working out. Now, let me say this with some emphasis. This is the easiest and most convenient gym watch I've ever used. It absolutely blows away the competition, mostly because the touchscreen and layout allow you to very easily log and make adjustments in a hassle-free way. That's something other competitors have not offered. Now, it's not perfect, but Garmin is now, in my opinion, getting very close to automatic gym-based exercise detection that is actually accurate and easy to use, and that's the combination that we're looking for. Now, additionally, the heart rate sensor for high intensity interval training, boot camp style exercises, and CrossFit style exercise, the heart rate sensor did remarkably well, and I think the lightweight nature of the watch helps its accuracy tremendously. This outperformed actually my Garmin Fenix 5X in terms of heart rate accuracy for all types of exercise, even though they technically share the same heart rate sensor. So for any strength training or gym-based exercise, if you're looking for a heart rate sensor that does a good job, and you're also looking to potentially tap into the automatic detection and rep counting that this offers, this is the best on the market. Now for steady state cardio exercise like jogging and cycling, it's a similar story. The heart rate sensor did actually outperform my Garmin Fenix 5X in terms of accuracy. But the Garmin Fenix 5X does give some additional advanced running and cycling metrics that you don't necessarily get on the VivoActive 3. But still, you get a lot of information. You get cadence information, heart rate information, speed, altitude, location, your VO2 max, recovery timelines, and graphs that chart many of these metrics over the course of your run or cycling. So you can see how hills and declines affect your exercise, your heart rate, your body, and all of that. And I found all of that information to be accurate and helpful, and I would say that this watch easily has the bases covered for those of you who are involved in cardio and distance-based sports.
So the VivoActive 3 you see here on my wrist is actually a review unit that I have to send back. So if I want to buy this, I have to buy it just like the rest of you. And actually, I kind of regret having purchased my Garmin Fenix 5X and not holding out for something like the VivoActive 3, especially now that I've had a hands-on and can see its capabilities, specifically just the gym capabilities alone. Now, if GPS and heart rate capabilities and accuracy are important to you, especially for cardio and distance-based sports, then the VivoActive 3 is absolutely no slouch.
So this watch definitely provided me with better heart rate accuracy than the old VivoActive, even better heart rate accuracy than, again, the Fenix 5X. This has more metrics that it provides to you, more metrics than Fitbit and Suunto provide. And this is where Garmin is simply beating the competition. You aren't going to get a better GPS watch experience than Garmin. You just aren't. You might get a better software experience maybe from someone like Fitbit, and you might get a cheaper watch maybe from Suunto, but you aren't going to get better GPS and heart rate accuracy for running and cycling than Garmin. Now, I did not take this watch swimming or golfing, but based on my previous experience using Garmin's golf and swimming features, you're looking at a very well-rounded and accurate sports watch that can track virtually anything that you throw at this. So this watch is more than just a cosmetic update. It's a massive leap forward for Garmin, and I give this watch a 9 out of 10.
So why not a 10 out of 10? Well, that's a great question. I think, first of all, that I would have liked to have seen music storage on the VivoActive 3. That's a feature that the Fitbit Ionic has, as well as some others. And I would have liked to see music storage on the VivoActive 3. So it gets, you know, a point docked for that. Secondly, I would have liked to have seen a more premium version of the watch. Now, don't get me wrong. I think it's a quality watch with quality design, and I think it's going to stand up to the rigors of the gym and exercise and cardio. However, I would have liked to have seen maybe something like an all-metal construction version of this watch versus kind of the polymer plastic version that they have. I would have liked to have seen something a little bit dressier, a little bit higher production and quality, an all-metal design. Now, obviously, Garmin would have probably charged an additional premium of $50, $75, or even $100 for that version of the watch, but that would have been something I would have been happy to pay for to get a version of the VivoActive 3 that was an all-metal construction. That being said, this watch is a fantastic option for those of you shopping under the $300 price point. As a matter of fact, I would even say that as of right now, this could be one of the best, if not the best, watches on the market in terms of all-day activity and sports tracking. Bar none, it's just a fantastic option at the $300 price point. So I'm going to put a link in the description below if this is something you want to pick up. The links will take you to either Amazon or Clever Training and give you the best price possible. Both Amazon and Clever Training have fantastic return policies, so I highly suggest that you use them in the case that you decide you don't want to keep the watch.
If you enjoyed this content, please consider becoming a Patreon supporter. The Patreon link is in the description below. Hey guys, thanks for watching. My name is Eric, and I'm the Techie Agent. We'll catch you next time.